When industrialist Henry J. Kaiser decided to build and market a new small car in America, he had the simplicity, the durability, and the sales success of the Model T in mind. Now, on paper, that all made sense. The new car would sell for around $1,300, and its small size and durable drivetrain would make it cheap to own and operate. Hi, I'm Joe Kelly Jr. This is Playing with Cars. Introduced in late 1950 and retired only 4 years later, the Henry J never achieved the sales success its namesake had hoped it would. Maybe it'll do better in scale. As the newest in the Sunstar Platinum series, the model's got most of the features and virtually all of the detail of the real car in 1/18 scale. Maybe they'll sell more than Kaiser did. In September of 1950, the Kaiser Motor Company introduced a new car for the common man. It was stylish with a bullet nose and tail fins. It was solid with relatively few steel stampings used for its body. And because of a 4- or 6-cylinder engine and standard transmission, it was also economical. After a much ballyhooed national name that car contest, they called it what they'd planned to all along, the Henry J. Kaiser left nothing to chance as far as shaving costs and saving dollars. The Henry J was a low-buck affair in the extreme. In base or standard trim, the car came without a glove compartment or roll-up rear windows. It didn't even have a trunk, and it wouldn't until U.S. dealers found out that overseas versions had them. Passengers up front had to deal with sunlight the old-fashioned way, by squinting, because the car didn't come with a visor on that side. What it did have was fuel economy in the 30 to 35 mile per gallon range, thanks to its 68 horsepower four-cylinder. Now, stepping up to the six-cylinder deluxe version got you some more power and slightly more pizzazz. That's the car Sunstar's delivered this time around. Now talk about pizzazz. With high-end chrome and usually flawless assembly, Sunstar's Platinum line is one of this scale's very best values in the bang for the buck category. This latest model only adds to that fact. Impeccably finished in this Indian ceramic color and in a companion release done in an eye-searing arena yellow, this late process pre-production sample of the car is so stuffed with detail and features, I can't put it down. The features start with opening doors and hood, all on great shut lines and realistic real aspect hinges. Added to that are a working suspension and posable wiper arms. Remarkably clear and well-placed lenses are set into the front and rear of the model, and they sparkle alongside the chrome appliques on the hood and rear deck and this needle-sharp hood ornament. The wheels steer and pose too. While they lack valve stem details, those wheels and tires are some of the best that Sunstar's ever done. Narrow, correctly sized, and holding the moderately heavy model at just the right ride height. It looks really nice from any angle, and it's a riot to see so much attention paid to such a humble automobile. Henry J's were pretty bare-bones cars, it's true, but adding a few amenities made them more like the contemporary base model Fords and Chevys they were trying to steal market from. And here's one of the places Sunstar's really stepped up to the plate. From the matted floor, the freestanding pedals, and the three-on-the-tree column shift, this replica's got a lot of separate castings all beautifully painted and placed. The dash has little ivory knobs and a sweet little binnacle, and it's got its own chrome applique badge. That's a really nice detail. The steering wheel looks scale correct too, and it's got a nice deco with its hub. The seats tilt, as do the visors. They and the pouch in the passenger's footwell were deluxe items. The back behind the seat is a neat sight. The stowed jack, spare, and tools. Now, these were bare to get to on the real car, and frankly, they're not a whole lot easier to get to on the model. The good news is you don't have to. They've been stowed neatly behind the rear window in a nice little tool tableau. Separately cast and chromed handles are on the vinyl pattern door panels, and the rubber sills trim the cabin off neatly and realistically. Again, a whole lot of great attention and modeling have made this area really shine in scale. Some models use a lot of high-end, noble materials to build detail onto their engines, and they cost like they do, too. Not Sunstar. They've managed to wrap serious stuff around their model of the little 80-horsepower 6, but instead of using steel or brass, Sunstar uses cast vinyl and plastic, and it works. There's incredible attention paid to the little stuff under here. There's a linkage to the carb, a full set of ignition wires, a cabled-in battery. I mean, you can, and I have, spent a lot of time under here just looking around. The different shades of gloss and matte black are authentic, as are the labels on top of the air cleaner and the battery. But my favorite details, aside from this metal prop rod, are the ones that I almost missed. The emergency brake cable that's winding its way up from the frame and into the firewall, and the tiny tin VIN plate up on its top. How cool is that? When Sunstar talked about this model a few months ago, they said the chassis would be nicely detailed, and boy, they weren't kidding. It's not hysterically so. The suspension up front is of the hidden coil spring variety, but the added e-brake cable, complete to the tensioning spring, and the nicely put up castings and added on fuel and brake lines and exhaust system look really cool against this deeply etched and cast plastic belly pan. You know, whenever a new Platinum model comes along, I have the same reaction. How did they do it at this price, and why? Why did they wait so long? These are phenomenal model cars. I recommend any of them highly, but I've got a special affinity for this Henry J because it was such a low-buck car, and they've done it just so well. Now, I do suggest if you are interested that you pre-order the car, just a precautionary thing against what usually happens when these Platinum Series models come out. Well, that does it for this episode of Playing with Cars. I've had a ball with this model tonight, and I hope you've enjoyed watching it as much as I've enjoyed bringing it to you. So until next time, for the Car Room Magazine, I'm Joe Kelly Jr. Thanks for stopping down, and thank you for playing with cars. Take care. Bye-bye.
Okay, Dad.